try very hard to be a patient person, but hopefully you can see this person there behind me, that person back there. I was sitting at our mall trying to turn out, and when you're leaving the mall, you have the stop sign to go out onto the main street. The people coming in do not have a stop sign. They have the right of way. Now, you have to understand, it's not even 11 o'clock on a Tuesday morning. No one in the parking lot, all right? Yes, this is a little rant, so just bear with me. But she comes up behind me, and I'm, of course, waiting for the all of a sudden stream of cars coming in off of the main street into the mall, and she proceeds to start honking at me. Yes, this car right there. I hope everybody can see her and can, you know, see her-ness, whatever. Made me so mad honking at me. So I did something I've only done one other time in my life. I put my car in park, I got out, and I went back to her car. And of course she was, you know, both hands on the wheel. Like, I'm just so intimidating of my whole, all of 5'6" stature. And she wouldn't roll her window down. And so I just kind of loudly said to her, they have the right of way. They do not have a stop sign. If you do not like how I'm driving, go around me or be patient. And I'm sorry, but I just feel that way in general about people. And seriously, it's like a huge big old parking lot, you know, two lanes, the whole deal, you know, plenty of other places to go if she did not like how I was driving. And normally that kind of stuff wouldn't bother me, but I tell you, just in light of so many things that are going on lately, I'm sick and tired of it. And a lot of people say, oh, don't do that, you're going to get your head blown off, someone's going to knife you or whatever. You know what? If they do, they do. If they kill me because I, you know, point out their idiocy, well then, you know what, I guess I should be dead. I don't know. But, yeah, it's people, you know, come on, just obey the traffic laws, drive safely, be careful, be courteous, let people in, you know, all that kind of stuff. It's like, come on, folks. And she didn't seem to be the brightest bulb on the Christmas tree, but still, I'm like, you need to be patient. And I think the other thing that bugs me so bad is that that's how Dallas drives a lot. And I left Dallas about 7 years ago. We moved down here to Austin. Generally speaking, people here in Austin are very patient and very kind when it comes to driving on the road, because that's just kind of a Texas thing. Even though Dallas is in Texas, it's, you know, more big city now. Dallas used to be that way, but it's not anymore. But I don't know. It just, rude drivers are rude. And I'm sick of it. And maybe I'm just getting to the point in my life where I feel like I'm entitled to gripe at people if they bug me. I don't know. But like I said, y'all know me. You should know me. I am who I am. I get real on these videos, so y'all should know who I am by now. I'm a very patient, kind person, you know, generous to a fault usually. But when people do that, I'm like, okay, do you want to drive my car? Is that why you're honking at me? You feel like you're a better driver than I am? Well, let's compare driving records, shall we? Let's compare the lack of speeding tickets on my record, shall we, in my entire existence of driving. I'm a little ticked off. Hey guys and dolls, I am here at my friendly neighborhood box store. I'm gonna try to show it to y'all. It's called Eco Box. And this location here in Austin is a little bit smaller, but it's closer to me where I live, and they seem to have all the different sizes of boxes that I need all the time, and so that's why I come here. But this is a good retail outlet, but like I've told you before in another video, if you have the money available and if you can do it, you might want to try Uline, and I think they have the website uline.com, because they have this more wholesale boxes. But here you can tell them, you know, you're a business, and they give you a discount. So I'm gonna go get some, actually not boxes today, I'm getting some padded envelopes.
Okay, I'm about to run out of battery, so I don't know if it's gonna cut off or not. But anyway, I wanted to show y'all, I got 12 of the number one bubble mailer. And I'm showing y'all this so y'all will do your own research in your own area. It's for the comic book size comics that I have quite a few of. I do hardcover books and the comic book collections, and then sometimes also just the regular thin comic books on there. And like I said, I did 12 of them for $5.59, and that included tax and everything. Yes, I do go ahead and pay tax. I don't do any of the sales tax stuff because it's just too complicated. I go ahead and pay the tax. But anyway, so 12 of these bubble mailers, usually for, you can get like two in a pack or something, and it's only in like 8x10 or something, you know, at the grocery store, whatever, or the office supply store, and it's usually $2 or $3 for just two. So don't do that, okay? You're going to waste money. I'm doing this to show y'all that your local businesses, like this is EcoBox, so if you're in the Austin area or if there's an EcoBox near you, I believe they also have an online, I'm not sure, check it, EcoBox.com maybe, I don't know. You could Google search it, but anyway, in your area, I can guarantee you that there's going to be a box place that does this. Just go into them and, you know, gather up your boxes that you're going to buy, and when you go to the checkout, just say, you know, I'm a business, I sell stuff online, can I get a discount? Just tell them that, because like I have not had to give them a tax ID number or anything, and they're very helpful, and they know me, they know my company by name every time I come in, and they are about to, you know, run it through. They go, that's Once and Again, right? And I said, yeah, because it's Once and Again Emporium is the name of my company. Wink, 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 if you want to go buy anything, wink, wink, do a Google search of Once and Again Emporium. I'm currently selling in eBay and in Amazon right now. It's November of 2012. You could check me on Bonanza. I may have some stuff listed on there right now. And, yeah. So, if you sell online, don't pay full retail for boxes. Okay, it's ridiculous. You've got to go somewhere where it's a box supplier. This is actually a moving box supply company. So, check that as well. Call before you go. Like in your city, if they don't have an Eco Box or if you don't have Uline, something like that. Make sure that you do some looking around and see moving box companies, and then see if they have, you know, small corrugated cardboard boxes, and padded mailers are really good.